For me, Peeta was an amazing character. I fell in love with him right away. And what was crazy to me is I've never seen a character that was so much of who I am as a person. I just feel like his kind of self-deprecating humor, his outlook on life and how he doesn't want things to change him was really kind of a part of who I am as a person. And you know, being in this business at a young age, from 9 years old, you know, there's a lot of times where you can let things change you and let people have a big effect on you, but just making sure that you stay true to who you are and what your value system is was really important to me since a young age. And I think that's something that was really attracted to me about Peeta, because that's how I am as a person as well. It was very nerve-wracking. It was at the point where I was so obsessed with getting the part that any time I was gonna say a word that began with H, I would say Hunger Games. Like, I'm so Hunger Games to be here. Happy, sorry, it's in my head. But yeah, it was a long process. You know, a lot of talks with like agents and stuff like that, and then going in and meeting with Gary. And actually I got to meet Suzanne Collins in the meeting for the first time, which was very exciting and nerve-wracking at the same time. But I had a great read-through with them, and then I came back to do a test screening a few weeks later. And that went great, and kind of hit it off with Jen, and really got to see the chemistry between the two of us. And a couple weeks went by where we couldn't even say a single word about it or talk about it or so much as think about it. And then we got the call, and it still didn't even hit me until like walking on set for the first day of how big it is. I play Peeta Mellark, and he is very much like myself. He's outgoing. He's very much a people person. He has a way of being able to talk to anybody he meets. It was great for me to shoot the scene where Peeta throws the bread to Katniss. Actually, we shot that at the very beginning of the movie, which was great, because that is something that's a very big driving force in the whole movie, in the book especially, is Katniss keeps on thinking about how Peeta helped her that one time, and she kind of feels this need to repay him in some way, and this kind of feeling that she can trust him. But Peeta sees her, and I think that he is very compassionate kind of guy, and he knows that he's not supposed to kind of go outside of his world because he has very overbearing parents. But he sees this girl in need, and he tosses her this bread, and this happens to be the girl that he's in love with. Katniss is the love of Peeta's life. She's from District 12 as well, and she's a hunter. She's a survivor. Her father got killed in the mines when she was younger, and her mom kind of lost it, and so she's been raising her family, basically. So she's very much a fighter, and my character Peeta has been in love with her since the day he first saw her. The reaping is the process of which they choose all the different tributes from the different districts. Peeta was drawn at random, was just, you know, poor him, has to do that. And then Katniss's little sister was drawn, which was like one in hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of chances that her name was gonna be the one that was drawn. And because it's Katniss's little sister, you have the ability to volunteer if you want to. So Katniss steps up and volunteers to save her little sister's life. Peeta's goal is to do everything he can to make sure Katniss can survive, because she's the love of his life. So for him, his ability to kind of talk with people and manipulate them, but not like in a conniving way, in a way to protect Katniss, that's really his strengths. Katniss Everdeen is played by Miss Jennifer Lawrence, the talented and beautiful. She's incredible. To me, Katniss is all about being a young, powerful woman who can take care of herself and others around her. Jennifer encapsulates that perfectly. She has this total sense of like hardness and independence about her, but then she has this vulnerability that's really beautiful and really genuine. Haymitch is played by Woody Harrelson, who is like the coolest guy in the world. He's so perfect for this role because Woody has a great way of kind of having this sort of carefree attitude about very serious things, which is sort of Haymitch's attitude a lot of times towards the games and everything about it. So I think he's just knocking that out of the park. He's absolutely perfect for it. Gary Ross is our director, our fearless leader. He's absolutely incredible. He has such an amazingly strong vision for this movie that I don't think I've worked with a director that has such a, like, I know what I'm doing, I know what I want, and he knocks it out of the park every single time. We shot all the arena stuff over in Asheville, North Carolina, which is an amazing city, by the way, one of my favorites. And probably one of the hardest things about shooting there was dealing with the heat and the costumes, because we had to wear these like jackets that are supposed to be futuristic, that when it's cold they stay warm, when it's hot they like let the heat out, but of course we don't have that kind of technology now, so when it's hot you just are in a jacket, so it's pretty warm. That was tough. The bugs were pretty brutal out there. We had bears, all sorts of other crazy creatures we had to deal with and stuff like that, but overall it was beautiful. It was a great location. I first read The Hunger Games when I found out I was being made into a movie. I was actually working on Red Dawn a couple years ago, and Connor Cruz told me about it. He said that they're making this awesome book series into a movie, and you gotta check it out. So my mom read it, and then she was like, it's amazing. So then she's like, you gotta read it. So I read it, and I just couldn't put it down. I was like reading and reading and reading. I wanted to find out what happens next. So for me, it was very captivating. We have basically, I think, like roughly 150 people working on set every day, not to mention the hundreds of other people that work in wardrobe department, construction, all sorts of things like that before we even get here. So that's huge, let alone the fact that our shooting schedule is crazy. We're shooting like 3 to 4 pages a day, which is sounds like nothing, but when you come down to like how many shots you have to have for each one of those things, it's an incredible amount of stuff. And everybody has to really be the best of the best to get this kind of thing done, and we've got the best of the best, and it's really great. For me, what's great about this movie is that it came from an amazing book that has really well-written characters. And for me, whenever you have such good characters in a story, you really care about them and you want to see what happens.